Good afternoon, everybody. I'll be talking about chandelier illumination assisted phacoemulsification in hazy cornea. Now, doing cataract surgery under conventional microscopic illumination in very hazy corneas like this is very challenging because of the poor visibility of the lens and anterior capsule during the surgery. So what happens in patients with corneal opacities, light from the microscopic illumination is when falls on the cornea, it gets scattered back. And this results in a poor red glow and hence decreased depth perception. Now various techniques has been described to increase the intraoperative visibility, like use of the trypan blue dye. So this helps to enhance the anterior capsule, but it doesn't help in the subsequent steps. And we can create sphincterotomies, but it's more traumatic for the eye. And we can use endoilluminators that can be placed either in the anterior chamber or via pars plana route. So we have various endoilluminators available, but why the conventional light source doesn't work well in these cases these days? Because with 20 gauge surgery, as we used earlier, the light sources like halogen and metal halide were used. But now, with the advances in the vitreoretinal surgery, we are shifting to the smaller gauge surgery. So with 25 or 27 gauge surgery, when we use halogen and metal halide sources, only 50% of the brightness is achieved as compared to the conventional light source. Now to compensate this decrease in the brightness, newer light sources are introduced like xenon and mercury. Increased lumens of light with the xenon light sources are substantial. Even with 25 gauge or 27 gauge surgery, we are able to achieve equal or more brightness than conventional light source. There are several light sources, xenon light illuminators that are available in the market: Photon, Brightstar, Constellation with Stellaris, PC. Mercury vapor illuminators are even more powerful sources than the xenon arc, with luminous efficacy reaching up to 402 lumens, giving us desired brightness. Now, the endoilluminators can be very easily placed in the anterior chamber, and it's very helpful in cases of mild to moderate corneal haze. The only problem is that you need somebody to assist you in holding the light pipe in position in interior chamber so that you can do bimanual manipulations during the surgery, which is not always possible. So why does the chandelier, how does this chandelier illumination work? So as we have seen that the conventional light source, when light falls on the cornea in cases of corneal opacity, it gets scattered back and this gives the poor red glow. While with the chandelier illumination, the tip of the endoilluminator is cone-shaped. It gives a very wide-angle illumination, and when the light falls on the retina, it gets reflected back. And this is what bypasses the corneal opacity and gives a very good red glow. So hence, when we get the good red glow, so there the subsequent steps are very easy for us. So these indications of this using chandelier illumination are especially patients who are one-eyed, who may be at high risk, who are high-risk candidates for combined corneal transplantation and cataract extraction, where we feel that the only cataract surgery can give them adequate vision. However, we are reluctant to touch such cases because of the poor visibility during the surgery. So here is the surgical video of one such case. So this is how, as Dr. Ritesh has described, this is how we place the chandelier illuminator via pars plana. We keep the illuminator vertical to get the good glow. Now this was a patient with very dense central corneal opacity. So once the you make your ports and stain the capsule with the trypan blue dye, for doing the subsequent steps, you switch off the microscopic illumination and switch on to onto the endoilluminator. And you can see that how good the red glow is. You're able to do the axis very nicely, and even the subsequent steps like chopping are easier. So during the surgery, if you feel that the glow is not very good, you can just tilt the illuminator so that you get the maximum brightness. even the margin of the interior capsule is visualized. Otherwise, in such a case, doing the routine conventional microscopic illumination surgery is very difficult. So the implantation of the intraocular lens is also very easy. You can clearly visualize the haptics and place the IUL nicely in the bag. And even the removal is very easy. So once the surgery is complete, you just pull out the illuminator from the pars plana area. So this was another case of blast injury where almost, zero visibility. But still we were able to complete the surgery successfully with the use of illuminator. So the advantages of the chandelier are, so it's a small gauge procedure. Design of the chandelier allows easy entry without doing any conjunctival peritomy. It's self-retaining, so allows bimanual procedures, so gives us wide angle illumination. There is fourfold increase in the contrast and twofold increase in the resolution when the illuminator is placed behind the cataract. There is very less corneal scatter and better interior segment visualization, and you can avoid the need of open sky cataract surgery, and easy to remove, and it gives a self-sealing wound. The only concern is phototoxicity. So, but newer illuminators like xenon, they are having lower wavelengths, so they cut off the ultraviolet and blue light. And phototoxicity is more of concern in retinal surgery because the duration of the surgery is longer. In cataract surgery, since it's a short duration surgery, it doesn't matter much. So to conclude, and chandelier illumination is a very useful technique to enhance the intraoperative visibility in dense or hazy corneas, and it gives us high intensity hands-free source of endo illumination. It can be safely adopted by most cataract surgeons in the presence of mild, moderate to even denser corneal opacities. Thank you.